Welcome to this channel, Gain Java Knowledge. And today in this video, we will learn how to enhance the application logging with Cell4j Mapped Diagnostic Context, that is MDC. And today in this video, we are going to add the MDC feature of the logging framework. So before MDC problems in logging, let's assume that we are going to develop a simple web application that contains controller and service layer that serves requests from multiple clients. So all the log message will give into a single log file. And when this controller is serving more than one client at the same time, the log statement will be mixed and there is no way to differentiate which log statement belongs to which client processing. This will make it difficult to trace and debug if any processing error occurred in controller request processing. For this purpose, to identify each client request uniquely, we need to add MDC feature in our logging. So now we will see how to identify log statement with respect to each client. And to avoid the mix-up of log statements, we can add a client identifier that can be any correlation ID or UUID to the log statements. So therefore, we need to make sure that client identifier is added to each log and statement of the application. For this requirement, we need to add correlation ID or UUID from our request header. But assume that the application contains thousands of log entries in hundreds of source file. And if we are going to add this manually, this will be a tedious and repetitive work that consumes more time and resources. Don't worry, this can be done within few seconds with MDC, that is Mapped Diagnostic Context, and it is used to support of the logging framework that you are using, like Cell4j. And what is MDC? MDC is Mapped Diagnostic Context that is used to enhance the application logging by adding some meaningful information to log entries. And Mapped Diagnostic Context is essentially a map maintained by the logging framework where the application code provides key value pairs which can then be inserted by the logging framework in log messages. And Cell4j also supports MDC. Okay, now we will create one simple Spring Boot project and see how it works. So here I have created one simple Spring Boot project. And in this project, I have created one controller class, that is employee controller. And this employee controller class contains only single endpoint that is used to get the list of employees. So here I have just added logger class of Cell4j. And inside this method at controller level, I have printed this log inside get all employee method of employee controller class. And when I will go to its implementation layer, that is its service class. So here it is also printing some logs, that is logger info inside get all employee method of employee service IMPL. And here I am just printing the list of employees. So here I have added two loggers and I have just created one simple endpoint. So here I have just created one simple model, that is employee, and it contains ID, name and salary, three attributes. And this one is the interface layer and this is the implementation layer. I have just created the list and returning the same list. So now I will run this application without using MDC. Run as Java application and we will see the difference how it works with MDC and without MDC. So here we can see logs has printed and now I will go to Postman and this is get type. So here I have added the method is get and URL is slash employees. Now I will send the request. And here we are getting the list of employees, employee 1, employee 2 and employee 3. And we can see the log messages here. So these are the log messages that we have added inside get employee method of controller. inside get all employee method of employee service, and this is the list of employees. But at a time, if multiple clients hit to the same request, then it will be difficult to identify which client have which request. So to identify the request for each client, we need to add some unique identifier or correlation ID. So what we will do for this, we need to add some value in our headers. Now what I will do, I will add one header values at our controller layer. So here what I will do, I will add @request header to identify the each request. So this will be the correlation ID, and this will be the string type, string correlation ID. So here I have just added one property in our header. So we need to pass this property value from our header. So now I will stop this application, but how we can identify each request? So what we need to do, we need to print this correlation ID also here. So if we will print correlation ID like this, then we can easily identify the request from each client, because every client will send different correlation ID. So now I will stop it and run the application again. Run Spring Boot MDC. So here application has started. Now I will hit it again. So I will go to Postman, and here I need to add value in our headers, correlation ID. So I am just passing some unique value like this. We can enter anything and sending the request. Now I will go to logs and check it. So here we can see correlation ID is also printed here, and we can identify the request from each client. But for example, if in our application there are thousands of classes, so we need to go in each class and each controller layer and each class service layer and need to add manually this correlation ID. So it will be difficult and the repetitive process. So no need to add like this, because if there are thousands of classes, it will take lots of time, and this will be the repetitive work. So to solve this type of problem, MDC came into picture. So we just need to add one filter, and then it will automatically handle and will print the correlation ID in each logs. So now what I will do here, I will create one filter that will handle this type of situations. For this, we need to create one package, that is filter package. And here I will create one package that is demo.filter, and inside this filter I will create one class that is unique identifier filter class. So here I will create one new class that is unique ID filter, and finish it. And we also need to create one configuration file. So here I will create one more package, new package, that is config package. And inside this config package, we need to create one class that is unique ID filter configuration. We can define any class name here. So what I will do now, I will go to unique ID filter, and here we need to extend a class that is once per request filter we need to add, and here we need to add unimplemented method that is do internal filter. Here we need to create the bean of this class. So here I will define @component annotation, and also need to define @data. So no need to write getter setter manually. And next thing we need to add equal hash code call super is equal to false. We need to define now what I will do, we just need to define three attributes, that is request header, response header, and third one is the key, because MDC also stored value in the form of key value pair. So this will be the key, and here I am just defining the constructors. One is zero parameter and second one is parameterized constructor, and we also need to define some constant in our configuration file. So first I will go to my configuration class that we have already created, and here I will just paste these constant values here, and here also we need to define @createConfigurationAnnotation because it's our configuration class, so Spring Boot will understand it's our configuration class. And also we need to define @DataAnnotation, so no need to write any getter setter here. And the next thing, we need to create the bean for filter registration. So here I will just paste it, and here we need to create the bean for filter registration bean. So just need to import it, and this is our unique ID filter, and here I am just passing response header, MDC key and request header also. And after creating the bean for filter registration bean, now I will go to my unique ID filter, and here we need to write code. So as we know that MDC also stored value in the form of key value pair, so we need to use this code here. So here we need to import MDC, that is org.self4j also supported this, and here we need to import our string util class. So here I have written one method that will return the token value that we are getting from our headers, or if you are not getting from header, then we will automatically generate here. So here we have just calling extract token method, and inside this token method we are reading request header value that we are passing, and from request header it will get the value. If we are not sending any value in request header, then it will automatically generate one random UUID and return to this function. And next we are just adding this key in and value into our MDC. So we are also adding this header value in our response. So when the request will goes and response will return, we can get the same UUID or correlation ID that we are passing. And in the finally, we just need to remove that it again. So we can add every time new correlation ID, and every time we will remove it. And we also need to override two more methods, because if multiple clients are sending the same request, then it can stuck. And to avoid this type of situation, we need to make it as a false by default. And here we have overridden these two methods, because by default this method returns true, and if multiple clients sending the request, to handle this type of situation we need to make as asynchronous. So here we have defined asynchronous as a false and should not filter error dispatch, then also it will work. If we will not override, in error case it will not work. So now I will just start the application and check if our in our each logs correlation ID is printed or not. So now I will just Spring Boot application, and here we can see in console. But before that, what we need to do, we need to stop it, and we also need to do one more change. We need to go in our application.properties file, and we need to define our attribute that we have added in our MDC put. And here we can see correlation ID is the our key and value that we are getting from here, from our headers. So what I will do now, I will go to my application.properties file, and here we need to define the log patterns for our application. So here I will just paste it, and here I am just printing the correlation ID that we are getting from header, and this is the key value for our MDC. Same value we need to paste here in our log pattern. Now I will run our application again and check it works fine or not. So now I will So here we can see our application has started, So here I have just started my application, and here I have added the correlation ID. That will be the same as request header that we have defined here, correlation ID. And now we can see our application has started. Now we just need to check if MDC is working fine or not. I will go to Postman and we'll hit the same request with correlation ID. So here I am passing our own custom ID and sending the request. And now I will go to console and check the logs, and here we can see correlation IDs printed with each log. And here we can see in our logs we have not added anything like inside our employee controller. We are just printing these logs inside get all employee method of employee controller, but we are not printing UUID or correlation ID. But this was happened with the help of our MDC filter. So this ID was also printed with each log. Okay, thanks for watching this video.